So we're going to start with some like terms. Some of you may already know what like terms are. So what are like terms? Well, like terms, as it says, the word like means similar terms, like the terms that have similar endings, or sorry, the exact same endings. So what I mean by this is, I'll give you an example like that. A, 2a, and negative a. These are like terms because they're all defined with a. Okay, so their pronumeral is all a. So that's why they're called like terms. So if I add them up, subtract them, I can gather them together, won't I? That's the idea of like terms. So if I give you another example, b, 4b and negative 2b, these are also like terms because as you can see, they all have b. It's not b squared, it's not b cubed, it's simply b. So these are all like terms as well. All right, now these ones, a squared, 3a squared, 5a squared. These are also like terms. Hopefully you all know why, because we all have a squared at the end. Okay, so a squared is common. That's why they're called like terms. Now this time we have ab, 3ab, negative 4ab. Now these are also like terms because they end in ab. All of them end in ab, so they're common. Ab is common, so therefore that's why they're called like terms. Okay, so it doesn't, just because they're like terms doesn't mean they only need one pronumeral. They can have couple, they can have three, four, even five, as long as they are the same, okay? Then they're called like terms. So you get the idea, don't you?